Very good morning, my dear students. Today is December 4th, 2017 and it is Monday. I am presenting you the newspaper analysis of The Hindu. My dear friends, if you count from today, you are having only 178 days left for your PT examination 2018. And daily, if you make a schedule that you are studying 10 hours even, then you are having only 1780 hours for your main PT preparations. And our approach is that for the GS paper 1, 2 and 3, we finish our syllabus in such a way so that in the main examination, there will be only revision part will be over. Daily out of the 10 hours of whatever the schedule you are making, you are devoting at least 2 hours for your newspaper analysis and 8 hours for your static portions. Newspaper analysis, news in focus, these all are the dynamic papers from here. At least 25 to 30 questions are likely to come. So this is very important aspect. It is very much logical that you must devote this much of time of your schedule for your newspaper analysis. Our approach is that we do pay emphasis, we make emphasis on those news which are important from our PT exam point of view. Today from the newspaper we are having the news which are important like the Baba Budhangiri. You know very well that Baba Budhangiri is in Chikmagalur district of Karnataka. And Chikmagalur district or Baba Budhangiri, it is on the western ghat. My dear students, I have always told you that anything which is coming from the western ghat, that is important. Regarding Baba Budhangiri, I have dealt earlier also in one of our newspaper analysis, perhaps in the month of October. And moreover, regarding this, in the classes of in Indian geography, the coffee plantations, that is in the agriculture, I have told the contribution of Baba Budhan for the coffee plantation. It is believed that he has brought the coffee beans to India for the first time from the Yemen when he has gone to Makkah for the Hajj. So these are the important aspects related to Baba Budhangiri. Let us see what is the news is there. In the news, this one, the saffron clad youth interdisputed Baba Budhangiri site. So what is the dispute point is there? Because Baba Budhan, the Dattatreya, etc., he is considered a revered figure by Hindus as well as the Muslims, Sri Guru Dattatreya Baba Budhan Swami. Regarding which one the news is there, because Hindu consider that this is the Swami is there, and the Muslim consider it's his Dargah is there. So this place is a matter of dispute for the religious fanatics people. But anyhow, this has come in the news related to coffee plantation. It is important for the historical perspective. It is important. Let us take a little bit view about the Baba Budhangiri. Baba Budhan was a Sufi saint. He was a Sufi saint. And Sufi saint, you know very well that Sufi saint was having the wide acclaim, wide popularity among the Hindu and the Muslims also. In most of the Hindus, they were revering the Sufi saints, they were respecting the Sufi saints too much. And in fact, we have found that in even so many Hindu houses, the Sufi's peer are being worshipped still today. It is a cultural tradition of India that in so many Hindu households, the Gosai or the house god, the god which is worshipped in the house, that is the Grih Devata, it is the Peer. So Peer and Banni Shahzadi, that concept is there, the Pancho Peer concept is there. Most of the Hindus are all still worshipping at their Grih Devata as a this Peer only. So Baba Budhan was having a wide acclaim among the Hindu and the Muslims, that is the 16th century Sufi saints revered by both Muslims and Hindus, whose shrine is at Baba Budhangiri. Baba Budhangiri, it is in the Chikmagalur district in Karnataka. It is also said that Baba Budhan has introduced the coffee plant to India by bringing 7 raw beans from the port of Mocha in Yemen. So in India, it has come from the Yemen, okay? So this is one important point from the civil services perspective in the PT examinations, that in those days, coffee was exported to other parts of the world in roasted or baked form so that no one could grow their own and were forced to buy from the Yemen people, because coffee was a kind of the currency at that time. What Baba Budhan has done that he brought seven beans because the number seven is considered sacred in Islam, and these coffee plants were then raised at the place that bears his name. So this is the popular lore is there, that popular folklore are there, that is during from the pilgrimage to Makkah he brought the coffee, and at present Chikmagalur, this place Chikmagalur is important for the Chikmagalur is important in the Western Ghats for the coffee plantations. The main peak of the Chikmagalur, this Baba Budangiri range is the Malayangiri. So this is important aspect, Malayangiri. They may ask this one, Malayangiri. Why? What is the importance of the Malayangiri? That it is a height of almost 2000 meter, 1895 meter precisely. So this is the highest mountain in the between the Himalayas and the Nilgiris. Malayangiri is the highest peak of the Baba Budangiri range, with a height of around this 1900 meter. It is the fourth highest peak between the Himalayas and the Nilgiris. So this is important aspect related to the Baba Budangiri. On page this one 6, we are finding some of the folk dancers. They are performing in some of the festivals. My dear students, regarding the folk dance and folk music, please visit our the site magnusis.com. That is the folk dance and folk music at the culture part. Here because we are always expecting, and this year I am truly telling you that some of the folk dances or the musics which are related with the tribals, that is very important, like the Sharhul for the Urao tribe or from the Chota Nagpur. This type of the dance, different type of the dances related to the tribals, these are very much important for this year. Manganihar tribe that has also come in the news sometime back, for which I have discussed in our views and news analysis. So this is important for your civil services exam preparation point of view, because one question likely to come from the folk arts and folk artists. The second lead article on the editorial page, that is a misleading hunger index. It is talking about global hunger index. Very important topic for your PT as well as for the main examinations. Here the author, they are very rightly telling that the global hunger index, it seems like a misnomer, because it is only talking about the child malnourishment most of the time, and other aspects are not that important. Let us try to recapitulate what are the important points from the PT exam point of view and from the main exam point of view. From the global hunger index, they may ask very simple questions, but that question will become important and it will be difficult also at the time of the examination. Like, global hunger index is prepared by which of the following? Okay, prepared by, like, they will give the option like WHO, they will give the option UNDP, International Food Policy Research Institute, World Bank. But my dear students, it so happens that unless you don't revise, you will forget. So Global Hunger Index is prepared by International Food Policy Research Institute. International Food Policy Research Institute. All the more, this is more important because India's score, the 2017, the Global Hunger Index score, has India ranked 100 out of 119 countries. And this is a very alarming situation. Last year it was 97. So this is the important aspect. It is also behind North Korea and Bangladesh, Iraq, but it is ahead of Pakistan. According to the report, it is also behind Nepal also. The country's serious hunger level is driven by high child malnutrition and underlies need of the stronger commitment in the social sector. So this International Food Policy Research Institute has ranked it 100. Last year it was 97. So this is a very alarming situation. Now some of the questions they may ask, that what are the things which this global hunger index doesn't count for? Basically, we have to understand that these are the 5 points on which they give their ranking. The first point is that is the percentage of population that is undernourished. Percentage of populations. So overall population they are talking. Percentage of populations. Now after that, we are finding that only child related matters are there. The child related matters, like The percentage of children under 5 who suffer from stunting, child mortality, undernourishment. So these all parts are there, the child which are not getting the nourishment, they are wasting. These type of things are there. The author here is telling that child constitute only 11.5% of the populations. So rest of the populations only 1 point is there. So from that aspect there the questions can be asked that in the main examination what type of the questions can be asked. My dear students, I am just writing down the question. You require to write a critical analysis of the this one, whatever the question I am asking, and you have to write down the answer. The question can be that Global Hunger Index prepared by IFPRI should be termed as Global Hunger and Child Health Index critically analyzed. If you analyze this question that it should be known as the Global Hunger and Child Health Index, what has been written by the editor, by the author in the third paragraph, that at this place, global second paragraph, in fact, Global Hunger and Child Health Index, you will find that all the data substantiate revolves around this one only. So my dear students, you require to take a pause, read this article very nicely and try to attempt a question on this aspect only. The next news that draws my attention, it is the Brahmaputra conundrum. Brahmaputra conundrum, that is a big problem, that is the regarding the water bomb, this concept we have discussed in the India-China relationships, that there are, they are not though admitting, but yes, there are chances that China can divert the Brahmaputra river, which is flowing in that their area, that is the Shangpo river, it is known Yarlung Shangpo, no? The name of Brahmaputra is Yarlung Shangpo. The author is telling that India should plan, because if China is, though they are not admitting that, changing the Yarlung Shangpo course, then what India should do? So they have to make a preparation for that. Besides, here one more important aspect that has come somewhere in the news in the second column, that is the Depsang Valley. Depsang Valley is important because Depsang Valley, some time back in 2013 perhaps, the China has sent its army and occupied, and they have sent, this one the disputed land which was taken in 1962 war, and China has again sent their army up to that place, but by negotiation this place was remained vacant. This is in the Ladakh region of the Jammu and Kashmir. UPSC are very keen for asking this type of the questions, they can, the Indo-China relationships, Depsang Valley. My dear students, if you just recall that the introduction to Indian geography, in that chapter India-China relationship, Indian-China border issues, these all aspects have been discussed. Please try to revise that one only. One extra effort has to be made for this one, the Lansang Mekong Mekong Cooperation. Here in the background is this map, that is the Mekong River from the China, the Tibet area is there, no? Okay. And this is the Mekong River, the Thailand and Cambodia, this is there. This project is very ambitious project for the China. Why? Because China will want to use water as a political weapon in its bid to become the regional and world hegemon, world dictatorship. So by controlling water downstream, it can hope to influence the Southeast Asian for key decisions, especially for the Asian summits. This was much more in news last year, so this is also important for this year, because UPSC sometimes asks the questions which has been important for the last year also. China wants to make 20 dams on this project, and which will use to replace the Mekong River commissions. Besides, China is also having the plan for, controlling the international river system, that like the Brahmaputra, Indus, Satluj, Salween, etc. So this type of the important aspects, because by this they can have the control over the India and as well as to some extent to Asia and the other Southeast Asian nations. From that aspect, this is very important from a civil services perspective. Just have a look into it. You go through the news analysis and concentrate on these areas and make a certain questions. The questions are available on our website also. Bitcoin is much more in news, a bit of a bubble. What is behind the Bitcoin boom? We have made a lot of questions from this Bitcoin also. So this is one important aspect. My restaurant is time for the revision of the Bitcoin notes of yours. Bitcoin is a cryptocurrency and it is a worldwide payment system. So it is a cryptocurrency and it is a first decentralized digital currency. In 2009, this came in the first time in the existence. The system works without a central repository or a single administrator. In fact, the network is peer-to-peer and transaction takes place between users directly through the use of cryptography without an intermediary. So no intermediary, that is important aspect, no intermediary. So these transactions are verified by the network nodes and recorded in a public distributed ledgers, that is important, public distributed ledgers. This is also known as the blockchain, LEDGER, no, it is also known as the blockchain. So this is the cryptocurrency, there is no intermediary, peer-to-peer, blockchain. Bitcoin was invented by one unknown person, and sometimes they are telling that yes, some Satoshi Nakamoto, Satoshi, S-A-T-O, Satoshi Nakamoto. The name is the pseudonymous person, it seems that he was there. And Bitcoin was created as a reward for a process of known as the mining. So Bitcoin can be mined also. There are the difficult computer programs. So these are the things related with the Bitcoins. Please do revise the notes after reading this article also. Related to disability, this is very important topic for the civil services. Related to disability, please revise the notes after reading this news only. Some of the important aspects are there, that is the UN Conventions on the Rights of Persons with Disabilities, UNCRPD, UNCRPD. So here you are getting some of the important data, and this data required to be written by you, and it has to be revised more often so that you can have a good insight about the disability, because this is very important for your examination. This news is also very much relevant for examination, that is the watch out ransomware. What is ransomware? That is important. Please do see and make a small write-up on the ransomware, because science and technology, these topics are important at present related to the cyber sector. In May 2017, if you recall, that news came related to the WannaCry, and I was expected a question in the civil services from this WannaCry. And the question has come related to this, the cyber security point of view. It has come because it was very much expected, and this was the expected question which has come. It was related to WannaCry. Those students who have not written the WannaCry and this type of the words in the keywords, definitely they will miss something. WannaCry attack was May 2017 worldwide cyber attack by the WannaCry ransomware crypto worm. It was a crypto worm, my dear students, please note it down, crypto worm, which targeted computers running the Microsoft Windows operating system, Microsoft Windows encrypting system, by encrypting data. And after that, the person who was doing it, he was demanding ransom payments. And he was demanding ransom payments in which form? In the Bitcoin. He told that, okay, I have encrypted your data, WannaCry ransomware, and that now there is the malicious program he has sent, and now is by the crypto worm, and now he's telling that you give me money in the form of the Bitcoin. Ransomware, what? Ransomware is a malicious software. So it is a type of the crypto virology that threatens to publish the victim's data or perpetually block access to it unless a ransom is paid. Means I will just disturb you, otherwise you pay me the ransom. While some simple ransomware may lock the system in a way which is not difficult for an eligible person to reverse, more advanced malware and uses the techniques called cryptoviral extortion. Cryptoviral extortion. Extortion amount they are asking, no? So this is the important key word. If something comes to the ransomware, then you require to write in your main examination, and it was supposed to be written in this year also. Cyber Swachhata Abhiyan, predation, cyber predations, ransomware, crypto, viral extortion, these type of words required to be written in this time of the new, I mean in the mains paper. In a properly implemented crypto viral extortion attack, recovering the files without a decryption key is a very great problem, and for that reason they asked for the ransoms. So WannaCry worm is an important ransomware attack. A typical carrier by using a Trojan, they use the Trojan also. Trojan that is disguised as a legitimate file. The Trojan files, they are disguised just like a legitimate file, and user is tricked into downloading or opening when it arrives the email attachment. So this is a type of the crypto worm extortion. This the crypto worm is there, and in such a way so they attack the system very well. So these all are the important aspects. In nutshell, I am telling you what we have studied just now. In today's news, we have studied Baba Budhanagiri, Baba Budhanagiri, recall it, Baba Budhanagiri, frame some questions, and those who have subscribed, they can send it to us so that I can reframe it and send it back to you for your revision purpose. Baba Budhanagiri, Global Hunger Index, Global Hunger Index, China's policy for the water related to Brahmaputra, Yarlung Tsangpo Brahmaputra, YSB, this one, LCM also. And then we have studied about the Bitcoin, we have studied about the ransomware, we have studied about the disability. So these are the important topics which we have studied today. My dear students, it's time for you to go in detail, frame questions, send it to us. Because by framing questions, your mental faculty becomes alert, and now you understand the things in proper perspective from a PT exam point of view, that how newspaper analysis can be used for the framing questions. So with this one, I finish this newspaper analysis of today.